So some of the folks working in the internet, or the early internet in Asia, attended SANOG and were very inspired by what they saw there, where operators of different networks who all compete with each other, but also were in the same room to discuss issues, collaborate, and so on. So that was the inspiration for formation of Apricot in the Asia-Pacific region. By the early 2000s, after the Asia financial crisis, 97-98, the internet in Asia grew absolutely crazy. You know, the needs of, for example, South Asia, so India and the countries around it, were very different from the needs of Indochina or even in Central Asia.
So we started SANOG in Kathmandu, and SANOG is like the South Asian Network Operators Group. It's kind of was based on Apricot, which is a big regional operations group in Asia-Pac, which is actually followed more or less after SANOG and the other ops group. The first SANOG did not have workshops, only training and tutorials. And that helped a lot of local guys to understand what it is all about. And then later that year, we actually did hands-on workshop again to have people get training. And back then, remember, we could not do virtual workshops, right? We had to ship equipment in, and we were not able to ship equipment in, so we got a ragtag lab with a bunch of borrowed equipment to get people to start doing some training. When SANOG was done again in 2004, we actually shipped, again with Philip Smith, his big trunk of routers into Kathmandu, and then, you know, we did a workshop that helped create a whole generation of folks. Actually, that SANOG was important not just for Nepal, but also for Bangladesh, and to some extent Bhutan, because we had a lot of folks come to that SANOG and do the hands-on workshop with Philip. From that workshop, a lot of participants have gone on to become trainers themselves, like Jihadul, Gigi Kabir, he was there. Chiring Norbu was there from Bhutan. And SANOG has been a very important part for us in Nepal, in South Asian region, in terms of educating and training people. From the initial trainings we did, we now have a big contingent of local trainers, like Ramkrishna Pariyar is there, Dibya Khatiwara is there, Kavindra is there, you know, who actually have gone on to become trainers at Apricot. And so they've expanded the scope so that they're going out of the comfort zone to become regional trainers.
SANOG started in Nepal, and then it covers all countries in the South Asia region. And this one meets twice a year to try and get around all the countries, because once it got going, the demand and the knowledge shared, again, the technical work is so big. The training, again, training was such a key role for this. And one thing that SANOG achieved very quickly was getting operators to actually talk to each other. And that's made such a big difference for the internet in that part of the world.
And what is helping is we also now have NPNOG, and then we have BDNOG in Bangladesh, we have BTNOG in Bhutan, we have PKNOG in Pakistan, and INOG, the regional pollination of ideas, probably will help take the best practices forward. And one of the things with the regional cooperation is, you know, the language and the culture are shared, right? It is easier for the researchers to collaborate with each other if they are close to each other, understand the language and cultures. And so that's why we had a big effort made to connect with the TN program. I think it was in 2008 SANOG, when we had a big focus on NRENs with TN regional meeting being held in Kathmandu alongside SANOG, where we brought folks from Bhutan and Bangladesh and, you know, encouraged them to join TN. And that kicked off a whole lot of downstream work. I think, especially with BDREN, they've been very active with doing a bunch of workshops, and we've sent people as trainers and participants. It is very close cooperation there.